Welcome to Can TV Hotline. Let's talk etiquette. It's amazing how time flies. Here we are just a few days from the end of 2017. What an awesome year. Also, it was a tragic year too. So we won't forget those who are no longer with us to celebrate the new year. So let's just have a silent prayer for them. Yes, now we are ending our show for this season. Can you believe that? 13 shows, and here we sit today. Well, because it's our last show, I want to do one extra thing for my audience. Call me first. That's the first thing I want you to do. This is Let's Talk Etiquette. So that means you're going to have to call me so that we can talk. Okay? And you can call me at 312-738-1060. The number is right there, so you see it. Pick that phone up and call me. But one other thing I want to do to end this year out and just acknowledge all of those mavens who have sat here and hosted this show. I think we've been on Can TV for at least maybe 7 or 8 years. We're closing into a decade on Can TV, and it's been an outstanding experience. But I want to acknowledge those wonderful mavens who sat here and hosted this show. And I'd like to start out with the first host of Can TV, Let's Talk Etiquette. And her name was Sandra Craig. What a great lady. I just can't describe, you know, that individual. She was a great lady. She was a great etiquette maven in every respect. From kindergartners through college age students, she did an outstanding job. And I want to honor her. She's no longer with us. Unfortunately, she went to heaven the first part of this year. And I can say she went to heaven because she was a wonderful human being, a very religious woman. And so we miss her, and it's hard to believe that she is no longer with us. It is really a hard thing to believe. But she did such great work serving the community and serving our children. And I just want to send a special thanks to her family. Let them know we love her, and she was very, very special to us. And then, of course, we had Gina Jameson. What a wonderful maven she is. And she was on the show just recently, one of the shows that we did in this 13 series. What a great, great person she is. And hopefully she'll be able to come back and be with us next year. Gina Jameson. If you remember the show she did, she interviewed a Congressman Danny Davis, for those who are longtime listeners. Then, of course, there was Madam Georgia Selman. What a great lady. What a great maven. What a great etiquette instructor she is. And, of course, this year we did Bloom Alternative School together, her and I. And those children just loved us, and we gave them so much knowledge about how to conduct themselves in society. And we went out and found jobs, prepared them to be employable, and they made $2,000 or $3,000 over this past summer, thanks to the skills that we taught them. And so I want to send a special thanks out to Georgia Selman, etiquette maven extraordinary, and she certainly deserved that title. Now, she was with us the first part of the year, but unfortunately she wasn't able to be with us the second part. We do miss you, and hopefully one day, maybe next year, you'll be able to return, and we're looking forward to it. So with that said, I want to go into our subject for today. Now, you remember last week, and in fact, the last 3 or 4 shows, we talked about etiquette-centered mentoring, and we've talked about etiquette-centered parenting. But we also talked about our program coming up next summer. that we want all of the mentors out there and the parents out there who want to get some of this knowledge and prepare themselves to be great mentors and great parents, please take advantage of this opportunity. It doesn't cost you anything. And in fact, the first 10 who register will receive a free etiquette book by the greatest of mavens of the 20th century. That maven is Emily Post. What a great servant to humanity was that lady. And just Google her name, Emily Post. And we're going to give you one of her books, the 15th edition. And she produced about 23 or 24 editions from 1924 to 1966. So we wanted to share that great wisdom of social behavior that she taught two generations, probably three generations, on how to be civilized and how to conduct yourself in society the way every human being should be conducting themselves. So that's for the first 10 who register with us. And we're going to put that information up there for you a little later in the show. But I want to start out just kind of going over what this particular summer class, we call it in summer etiquette camp, okay? But it's for adults. And so your children are invited. We want them to be a participant. If you can bring them, we've decided on a time that will make it easy for you to bring your children, okay? Let me put that information up to give you an overview of what we're going to cover. The Etiquette Foundation of Illinois, EFOI, that's what that stands for, EFOI 2018 Summer Etiquette Center Camp. What a title, huh? 5-day mentoring and parenting workshop. Date, Monday through Friday, time, 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. The dates, June 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, and the 15th, which is a Friday. So 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock. Now, all the classes may not go 2 hours. It may go an hour and a half or whatever. But I want to have enough time so that we can thoroughly cover the subjects that we're going to cover each and every one of those days. We want to get it over with. But we want to give you a real comprehensive overview of this thing called etiquette-centered mentoring as well as etiquette-centered parenting. And yes, you can bring your mentors, your mentees, and you can bring your children. Okay, parents? As long as they're obedient, okay, and not disruptive. Okay, the first day on a Monday, we're going to do an introduction to etiquette, the social graces, etc. And we need to give you a foundation of what this society represents, what Western culture have represented for the last 2,000 years. Okay? So this is the history of Western culture for the last 1,500, 2,000 years. Okay? So we are finally at a point where we are now can declare ourselves to be civilized. Okay? And that's an important state of mind. That's an important reality. Being civilized. Civilization. When we stop being barbarians and savages, every man for himself, every woman for herself, we decided to organize around this concept called civilized behavior or the advent of civilization. Okay, so the word is really connected with who we are today. So it's those thousands of generations that came before us who laid this foundation that we now stand on. Thousands of generations that have laid that foundation and who have articulated what it is to be civilized, okay? So that we as a union can come together, and now we're over 300 million just in this country. We as a union, we can come together and coexist and work towards the benefit of everyone. This is what society is. We are collaborating, we are interacting, we're working to create a reality for everyone to have a decent state of existence, where all the basics are in place. You know, I should feel safe. I should feel secure. I should feel all of the things that I want to be able to become and to do and to contribute. And if we are working together towards that end, then we are a citizen of a civilized society. And you should not have violence. You should not have criminality. None of that should really exist. But of course, uncivil behavior is unfortunately a part of the reality of the day. I have a caller. Caller, you're on the air.
Yes, Miss Wright, how you doing?
Steve, how are you, sir?
Man,
Merry belated Christmas to you, sir.
And you also. You know what?
Yes.
It's just, I was just listening to the beginning of your show, and I just told my wife earlier, I said, I bet you anything Mr. Wright would be there. Then when I remember the first day you came on. This is going to go off a little of what you're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
You are one heck of a person. It just shows you good things continue to move. Bad things always try to continue to move, but they don't catch up with goodness.
Absolutely.
You are one hell of a guy.
Thank you,
sir. You are one hell of a guy.
Thank you.
I mean,
we need to
you
meet.
Take your time
Let's
out.
Make that happen.
You take your time out every week to come and try to educate us. And I think that is so wonderful for you. And listen, I wish I knew today was your last show, because you know I would have a pizza there for you. But listen,
we'll do it when we come back in the spring. We'll be back.
Don't worry, I will. I promise you.
Yes, I want you to be a guest on the show.
Some things,
can you promise me that?
I promise you.
I want you to be a guest. I want you sitting right here next to me. Can you do that for me?
Okay, listen to me. I might be leaving. I'm thinking about moving down to El Paso,
okay.
Texas. I lost my mother not too long ago.
Yeah, my condolences.
My wife had a cardiac arrest, and she's been going through things. That's why I don't get a chance to see you that much.
Okay.
And it's just a slow recovery. So I'm thinking about gathering up all things, get rid of it, material things I don't need anymore. And it's time for me to enjoy my family.
I agree.
But one thing for sure, Mr. Wright, you have been a pleasure to me.
Thank
to
you.
Just to watch you,
you,
to hear you speak. Things, you know, you're talking about Emily Post. A lot of people ain't going to remember that.
Right.
But let me tell you something. Just show you how goodness continue keep on going.
Yes.
You taking over for her. And one day, it's going to be another person take over you.
There
and that's
go.
Only through you. So listen, I want to just say this, Mr. Wright. I have enjoyed you over the past.
Thank you for being a
You have meant a lot to
sure.
me. I thank you, one heck of a man. When that day comes, God got something for you.
I believe that.
And one thing for
that.
Sure, you put pleasure in my heart. So I want to just say this to you. I want you to have a wonderful, wonderful holiday. I want you to be safe every day, getting from point A to point B, because it's really crazy out here.
Yes.
But I really believe you are covered, so you don't have to worry about too much of that.
I do believe
But let
that.
Me tell you something, Mr. Wright. Keep those knots tight. Keep that smile on your face.
Yes.
If I'm here, I reassure you, I will see your first show. I will get in contact with the CAN TV people,
Please.
And they will let me know when
yes.
you're back on the air.
Back on the air.
Mr. Wright, you mean a lot to me.
Thank you.
And I know if somebody else want to get on the air. And listen, all any of your listeners, I'd like to wish you all a wonderful holiday.
Well,
Please be
you.
Safe. Mr. Wright, I'm going to miss you until next time.
Yes, we'll be back
I
in
want
April.
You to have a good night.
Thank you. Thank
and
you, Steve.
Let me get out there.
Thank you, Steve.
It's not goodbye, but we will see each other again.
Yes, sir.
I want to hear your response.
Yes, sir.
Thanks
Thank
for
you,
taking the call.
Yes. Well, what an individual. What a human being. And that's all I can say about this person. He's a great human being. He's the kind of human being that represents what we all should represent. All of us. There's no reason for us to represent anything less. We don't have to represent anything less, because we have everything that we could possibly want. It's right here for us, and we don't even appreciate it. And Steve, you're absolutely right. Send me an email. My number is 708-261-4547. Call me. I want to come to you, and we can go and have lunch, have some tea. We've been knowing each other 6-7 years, at least. So we haven't seen each other face to face. So lunch is on me. Just give me a call, okay? And I will be wherever you at, and I will chauffeur you around. Okay, Steve? Thank you for that call and that compliment. That was a really great compliment. And it makes me feel like what I'm doing is worth it all. It is. And that's validation. Thank you, Steve. So back to the show, but call me like Steve did. Give me a call. I'd like to hear from you. We're closing out 2017. And we're looking forward to a great new year. I mean, I am so excited about the coming year. I'm just boiling over with excitement. And so many things have come to me. God has blessed me, truly blessed me. You know, and if you were close enough to me, or if you were my Facebook friend, you will see my blessing. And that's what good citizenship is all about. And if you care about your fellow man, and you go out of your way to show that, the blessings will come to you. I can attest to that. And Steve, if you call me, I'm going to tell you about my most recent blessing. I mean, you won't even believe this. And this came to me through mentoring. One of my mentees that I taught at DePaul University has put a blessing on me that I would have to tell you face to face for you to believe it. But if you go on Facebook and put in my name, you'll find me and you'll see what my blessing has been. And that's being true to God's word and loving your fellow man. If you can do that, all of your sacrifices will come back to you tenfold. Tenfold. And it just fell out the sky. Literally fell out of the sky. That blessing. So call me and I'll share it with you and I'll take you out and let you see the blessing. You won't believe it until you see it. You will say, my God, that is a blessing. You have received one of God's blessings. Okay? So with that, I conclude and look for your call, Steve, and I get back to what we're going to be talking about in June with this etiquette-centered parenting and mentoring. Let me get back to the subjects that we're going to be covering. Okay, the second day, introduction to parentology, okay, 20-year plan. And we're going to explain that 20-year plan to our parents and even the mentors who are there, and so they can understand what your mission is in life. If your mission is to get a college degree and you spend 20 years to get it, then your mission as a parent is to spend 20 years raising your child, educating your child to be the greatest human being to walk planet Earth. That should be your mission. You may not get there, okay, but you want to give it 150% of your time and energy. That's your creation. You brought that child into the world. You didn't have to do that. Don't drop the ball. Don't let all this other nonsense distract you from your mission. If you don't want to be a parent, you want to be absorbed by all of this stuff that's all around you, and you just all excited, and my phone is ringing. I got to go and do some tweeting. Then don't have any children. Devote your life to that, and that's what's going to make you happy. It's okay. I'm not mad at you. Okay, but once you create a life, you have a primary mission to get that individual from birth to 20 years so that they can be a great human being, a great citizen, okay? And it's up to you to put what that child need in their head to be able to do that. And at the end of the day, you want them to be self-sufficient. So we're going to be covering that in detail if you participate in this summer camp we have planned for you in June. Okay, let's go to the next one here. Introduction to the philosophy of mentoring. This is a philosophy behind being a mentor. I mean, you really have to understand what you're trying to do. You got to have a faith in what you believe you can accomplish. If you're just doing something because it's a word and you just playing around and not serious, then don't even waste that child's time. Because you're going to have to be at a point where you can see into that child's soul. That's where you got to be with that child. So you can see into that child's soul. Because that's where you need to be an effective mentor. See, if you can't connect with that person on that level, you really can't contribute what that person needs to be the greatest human being. So be a mentor 150%. So be in the class. Come and be a part of it. It's the philosophy of mentoring. That's what we're going to cover. The next one is introduction to table and dining etiquette so that you can teach them some of the fundamentals of how to dine at the table. Okay? They need to know that. If you're talking about a six-figure individual and traveling all over the world and being a part of the movers and shakers, you're going to need to be able to know how to dine. That's just simple. You can't play with it. We have a caller. Caller?
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, sweetheart. This is Paula. How you doing?
Hi, Paula. How are you? Thank you for calling.
Okay. Hope your holidays is too bad. It's the last show.
Oh, yeah.
But I know you got a lot of knowledge behind in that little head you got there on TV.
Well, thank you, Paula.
What I'm trying to say for the people in the future as far as etiquette or anything else, it don't matter what kind of job, what kind of career you have, as long as you give it the best that you can.
I'm just a waitress.
I've been a waitress serving bacon and eggs all my life. But you know what? I'm on the top of my game.
Yes.
I enjoy it. I enjoy people. I know it's not the best job in the world.
Yes.
I didn't finish my education being Italian.
Right.
But you can do it.
You
have to take it something, even if it's working in a hot dog stand,
yes.
Even if it's selling shirts, shoes,
yes.
Something that makes you feel good when you get up in the morning. You got a reason to get up in the morning.
Yes.
And you got a reason to go to bed at night. And
so
it's
true.
Been a real
and
pleasure.
I was a waitress.
And I don't know
when
you're coming back. So you have a blessed evening.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you, Paulette.
Okay.
Appreciate you. Thank you for calling. And
more than welcome. Power to the people.
Absolutely.
Power to the people.
Power
it's
to
all
the
up
people.
To you.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And
good night, sir.
And you're quite right. There's dignity in everything you do that serves your fellow man. And that's what gives you joy. That's what gives you pleasure, to be able to create some happiness for someone else. And you do it so well. I can see you now on your mission. I don't want to call it your job because it becomes a mission. You're going in there to create happiness through serving a person a meal. So I've done that, so I know the pleasure. I've worked extra hard to get a bigger tip. So I know the joy of being a servant to others. And it's no different than what I'm doing. You're just doing it from a different perspective. So thank you. Let me get to this last one here because my time is fleeting, okay? Okay, let me get to the last one here. All right, the last wrap-up of our etiquette-centered parenting mentoring workshop. It's going to be a wrap session, so parents and their children, mentors and their mentees, wrap session. So we're going to cover all of the things that we think is important. We're going to allow our young people to get up and talk about their time on the planet and what are the issues that they are confronted with and how we as adults, as leaders in the community, can help them navigate this tremendous, difficult task of growing into adulthood and all the challenges and all the things that are being thrown at our young people. But first, before we close, this is our last show. I want to give you our contact information so that you can definitely give us a call. But we prefer if you send us an email. Please, just send us an email. That way we have a record. So it's it's info@efoi.org. See it there, info@efoi.org. With that said, thank you so much. Have a wonderful, safe new year. And we will see you next year on Let's Talk Etiquette. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.